Vault 95. Let's head inside and find a clean room. That's where we can get this crap out of me body. Something's ghosting us.
Weapons hot.
Huh? Hey.
If I find you, you're gonna regret it.
go.
Make that thing pour you a drink, and I'll be impressed. Whoa, whoa. You hear that? Come on! You mean that's it?
Engaging hostile!
Something's ghosting us.
Got it.
I have seen reports of some fatalities, but my understanding is that things are now under control.
That's it.
Psycho, Jet, hell, it's all here. Why would there be a stash in this vault? Unless, oh, vault tech, those animals. Experimenting again, I bet. Looks like they had their support meetings in the overseer's office. Sitting around and telling everyone else my problems isn't my idea of fun. You wouldn't catch me dead at one of these support meetings. Ugh. Don't leave anything behind that might be useful.
Contact!
Thank you.
Got it.
This must be it. The clean room. The answer to me problems is sitting in that room. But I don't know if I should go through with it.
If you don't go in there, you could die.
I know. But what if the psycho's the only thing keeping me together? What if this opens me eyes and I don't like what I see? There were reasons I dulled the pain. Things I didn't want to face. Things I was trying to forget. I'd rather be spitting blood than relive in the past.
I don't want to lose a friend.
You'd really miss me, wouldn't you? Well, who the hell am I to let you down? I'm gonna sit in the chair. Whenever you're ready, you go ahead and throw the switch.
Are you all right, Kate? How are you feeling?
Strange. I feel really strange. Everything feels different. Everything feels clearer. Colors, sounds, smells. Nothing is like I remember. I can't believe it worked. The cravings, the pain, hell, even the rush, they've disappeared. Was I really that far gone?
I'm glad that's over with.
I'm betting you're not the only one. I have a feeling that Tommy had this in mind all along. Clever old bastard kicked me out of the combat zone so I'd clean myself up, and somehow knew you'd be up for the challenge. I guess he saw something in you that I missed.
I take care of my friends.
I know you do. Look, I'm never gonna forget what you did for me today. You stepped up and helped when everyone else cashed out. I know I suck at thank yous, but that's the best you're gonna get out of me. Now, how about we get out of here and leave this place far behind? Found the good stuff. Take a look.
Bingo. Excuse me.
Hey, Scaver. Let's trade.
Anything been happening around here?
If you don't mind, prefer to just talk shop for now. A lot of quality goods here.
Let's see what you have.
do you quick.
Hey there.
Hey. Thanks for your help.
Oh, sorry. Thought you might be one of those forged maniacs, but you don't have the burns. A group of them took over the old ironworks, and they'll shoot you just as soon as look at you.
Who are the forged?
Bunch of trumped-up raiders, obsessed with fire and metal. That bastard son of mine, Jake, snuck out in the middle of the night to join them. He grabbed my granddad's old sword. It's the closest thing I've got to an heirloom. I don't guess you'd be crazy enough to try and get it back for me. I've got caps, if that's what you want.
Industrial buildings like that are pretty dangerous.
I see where you're getting at. 200 caps if you can bring it back for me.
Sounds like this isn't some normal group of raiders, either.
All right, all right. How's 250 caps sound?
Bet a weapon like that is worth more on its own.
You want my shirt while you're at it? Fine. 400. But not a single cap more.
What about your son, Jake? You don't care what happens to him?
I didn't raise my boys to be raiders. As far as I'm concerned, he's dead to me.
Can you tell me anything else about the Forged?
They're led by a guy named Slag. Came in from outside of the Commonwealth a few months back and started recruiting. Mostly they've just been strong-arming folks. But with how quick they've been growing, it's just a matter of time till the raids get worse.
What kind of a sword am I looking for?
One of them old pre-war swords, rigged up to shoot flames from the blade. Probably why Jake thought they'd let him join. So, what do you say?
I'll find it.
You're doing me a big favor, and I'll make it up to you as best as I can.
Something's afoot.
Security's too good.
Show your face! Come on, I dare you.
No sign of him now.
Nice.
I has gone 0 day.
This is bullshit.
Without an incident.
Attention. Fugitive should be considered armed and dangerous.
Thank you.
weed.
Tries to leave, kill him.
You must be pretty strong to make it here.
Oh, were those your guys? I thought they were just trying to throw me a barbecue.
Huh? Like your style, stranger. Been a while since anyone had the guts to talk to me like that. See, Jake? Here's someone who might actually be worth my time. Unlike you.
But...
you're gonna kill me.
But I brought everything you asked for.
Stealing things from your family farm doesn't prove your strength, boy. Though this wonderful sword you brought does put me in the mood to give you one last chance to prove your worth. What do you say? Kill that prisoner and prove that you aren't completely useless.
You said we'd be raiding outside the Commonwealth. These people aren't even a threat to us.
Prove to me that you can kill! It's him or you.
Oh God, what do I do? What do I do?
Walk away, Jake. You
please
don't
let
have
me
to
go.
You're right.
Gonna be, Jake?
I don't want to do this.
I don't want to join the Forge. I just want to go home.
Last
this
chance.
Place is just full of charm, isn't it?
Listen, before I count to three. It's over. One.
Help!
Two! Three!
What's
we're
that?
Down, little.
People, just leave us alone!
Wait, I'm sorry. I messed up. I panicked.
What were you doing with those guys, anyway?
I thought we'd be raiding outside of the Commonwealth, and that if I joined them, I could provide for my family.
I don't know.
God.
My dad's right. I'm such an idiot.
Look, I should probably try to go home and make amends. I know I've got no right to ask, but I bet if you're there to explain, things with my dad would go easier. I bet if you bring my great-granddad's sword, he'll make it worth your while. He always tries to deal fair with people. I'll wait for you by the overpass near the farm. I'm so nervous. I feel like I'm gonna throw up.
Here goes nothing.
What the?
Boy, I told you that
Abraham,
if you ever showed you a face
on?
Here again, I...
Is that my boy come home?
What?
Jake's back? Oh, thank God.
Papa, please. I know I screwed up pretty big. I thought if I joined up, I could keep them from raiding our farm.
I didn't. I don't want to hurt anybody.
I don't care what you thought. I told you.
Abraham Francis Finch, that's enough.
Mama, if...
Shut up, Jake. If I hear anything out of either of you, you'll both be peeling potatoes for the next year. I've watched you two go at it for years and tried to let you sort it out for yourselves. Abraham, your son is a grown man. And if you expect him to act like one, then you'd better stop treating him like a child. Jake, your father and I have been out there, and we know it can be dangerous. We just want to make sure you're prepared. There, it's over. And if I hear another word about it from either of you, so help me.
She's right.
Hi, how are you?
Hey there.
She's right, I've been a fool. There's no way I can thank you enough. Here's something for your help. I think you should hang on to that sword. It'd put a smile on Granddad's face to know it was being used to help people.
Sir, if I might bend your ear for a moment.
Of course, go right ahead.
So gracious, sir, I do appreciate it. I've always had such admiration for you and your family, ever since the day my visual senses were first switched on. You and the missus, so good with young Sean, and so trusting of me to look after such a newborn bundle of joy. It just warms my nuclear core. So, you can imagine the distress I felt when the bombs fell, after you fled to the vault. I searched, but found no evidence of your death. I could only hope you all made it in time. And when you returned, I was overjoyed. I admit I ran a full diagnostic scan just to make sure I wasn't malfunctioning. But the news of the missus and Sean, believe me when I say it takes a true hero to live through that.
I'm just doing what it takes to survive out here.
Oh, it's so much more than that, sir. So much more. In such a bleak world as this, think of all you've witnessed and all you've done. In my 200 years, I've seen it tear good men and women apart. But you, sir, you have remained the very model of what humanity should aspire to be.
I didn't realize you felt that way, Cosworth. I don't know what to say.
You don't have to say anything, sir. I just felt you should know what you've come to mean to me. I truly believe if the Commonwealth is to turn itself around, you're the one to do it. Now, not another word. I stand firm in my belief. Let's get back to it.
Anything else need doing?